Good morning. I have a different venue today. I'm coming to you live from my beautiful hotel room in Fort Worth. And I'm drinking yucky hotel coffee. I usually have flavored creamer every morning and they don't have any, so I'm really sad, but it's caffeine, so I'm gonna power through. And I didn't sleep last night either. I don't sleep well in hotels ever. But especially ones where I'm by myself. So anyway, good morning. Happy Saturday. We're going to be talking about B words this morning. And before you think I'm saying something bad, our B words are our statements of being and what we want to be more of this year. So I'm going to cover a little bit more of that in a minute. I am here in Fort Worth because my daughter Aubrey is a student at TCU and she is also a Chi Omega, and it is Mom's weekend. So we are having all kinds of fun stuff going on. Yesterday we did a paint party. So we painted sunflowers, and I should have brought mine in. It's still out in the car. let's just say I'm not a painter. We'll just leave it at that. Aubrey's a much better painter than I am. When we were done, Craig asked her to send a picture to him of our paintings. So she did and said, "Guess whose is whose?" I said, "Oh, he's gonna know right away." And he did. Mine was the one that was not so nice. But we had fun doing that. And then we went to dinner and got some Mexican food last night, which was fun, and did a little bit of shopping. And then we went for foot massages. And I've done foot massages before. But last night I did my first one that was real reflexology, and it was crazy. I felt like the guy was a psychic. Aubrey and I were laughing the whole time because he was pushing on different like parts of my hands and feet, and then he would say, like, he pushed on part of my hand. He's like, "Is that tender?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Oh, your lower back is hurting." And I was like, "Yeah, that's true." And then he started pushing on my feet, and he's like, "Oh, your sleep is so. You don't sleep very well." I'm like, "Yeah, that's true." And what else? I don't know. But every single thing that he pinpointed was so me. And Aubrey was cracking up laughing in the chair beside me because she realized how accurate everything was. But when I walked out of there, I've never felt so relaxed in my entire life. I felt like a spaghetti noodle. So I don't know what he did, but it was truly magical. Anyway, back to today. So we're talking about B words, and in yesterday's video, I shared with you that one of the things we're going to do this week, when we're talking about relationships and personal development, is we're going to go back to our week one goals that you set in this area. So you're going to be working on those in conjunction with the videos and exercises that we do throughout the week. So keep that in mind. You're going to be doing more journaling than normal, more introspection than normal, which is totally, it goes hand in hand with everything that we're doing this week. And we're kicking it off by coming up with three B statements. And I used the word, I said B words, which is basically the same thing. But anyway, for the year ahead. And these are the three things that you want to really focus on. If you can't come up with three, it's okay. If you only come up with one, then that's perfectly fine. But I used an example in the video of mine from 5 years ago, and I believe they were like, be joyful, be loving, and be, I forget what the third one, I forget the third one already. But these are going to change for you over time, and you're going to have different things that you're going to want to work on and keep front of mind for you that are really relevant to the life stage that you're in right now, the season of life that you're going through. So I had to refocus on this and decide what my three B's were going to be for the year ahead. And one of them I've shared with you before is be visible. I feel like as an introvert, my tendency is to want to hide behind things and stay in my little cave. And I've struggled through the years with being the face and voice of GYPO, which is completely silly because there's no way that I can separate it from me. I feel like it's my baby. And yet, that tendency was there to just kind of want to hide behind it, which, if you're an introvert, I'm sure you totally understand. So that's one of the things that I've really been working on this year, was just to be visible. And I think that's kind of like my overriding theme for the year. And also, yeah, I don't know how to address this, but it's something that I've started to notice as I'm getting older. I used to follow a blogger, and I didn't even plan on talking about this, but Okay, I need to, right? So I used to follow a blogger years ago when I started blogging, and I want to say she was in her 50s, maybe 60s, and she did blog posts about feeling invisible as you get older as a woman. And I am starting to experience that a little bit, and it's so weird, like especially when I'm with Aubrey, I notice it more. And granted, she's 20 years old and beautiful and blonde, and there's like everybody looks at her. But anyway, it's weird because when we're at dinner together and things, like the people in the restaurants address her instead of me. And I don't know, just like subtle weird changes are happening that I hadn't noticed even like 3 or 4 years ago. So I get this, like how as we start to age in society, and please tell me I'm not alone in this. I don't think I am, but I'm starting to feel a little less visible. And that's been a struggle for me. And it's really weird. Like even when we're in restaurants, like last night when we went to dinner, I was thinking the whole time as the waiter's like totally pouring all of his attention onto Aubrey. I'm like, who's deciding your tip here? I know that's silly, but it's weird. And I think it's something that we need to talk about. And I don't even know, I don't have the answers. And maybe there are women who have come ahead of me that do understand this. And I think this is something, you know, that I remember my mother going through. But it all has to do with this be visible thing. And I'm not sure how visibility changes as we get older, but it's something that I want to start exploring. And I think that that kind of falls under this whole theme for me, even though I'm looking at it, I started out looking at it from a different perspective. It means something deeper for me now. So anyway, I don't have any answers there. I'm just sharing from my heart how I'm feeling right now as a 45-year-old woman. It's interesting to see the way that we're perceived in society as we start to get older. And I feel like I'm at a point in my life too where I feel like I have grown into my gifts and I have more confidence and more wisdom and more to share. And it's an interesting perspective to have, you know, just to start feeling that way, where on the inside I'm feeling that way, but the outside view may not be the same. So anyway, yeah, just throwing that out there to share with you this Saturday morning. All right, so that's my visibility statement and my be what's falling under the be visible thing. So my next one is be present, and this is something that I feel like I'm usually pretty good about. But you know, it's an issue in society in general. You know, we have rules in our family about no phones at dinner, and I find that even just, you know, with my business, it's hard because I love what I do, so it's difficult to shut down and turn off and focus. So that's something that I need to work on a little bit more, and just being in the moment, not just talking about electronics and social media and all that stuff, but really being in the moment more, not thinking about the past or the future, but just truly being right now, because right now is all that we have, right? So I think it's really important to work on being present. And then my third B word for the year is to be you. Again, this goes back to a lot, it kind of, there's like a common thread that ties all these together, but I feel like, again, that we show the world what we want to show the world about ourselves, and we're not always vulnerable in sharing our stories and, you know, our experiences. And I think that's something that I need to do more of. And just recently, but you know, just through doing this challenge, and if you got my secret email yesterday and talking about my path with my career and how I got to GYPO, I got so many, I heard from so many of you yesterday that that email just totally resonated with you and where you're at right now. So, really just sharing more of that and more of the vulnerability and more of our stories and experiences. And I think that's something we can all do more of. Maybe you guys are already really good at that, but just understand that there's something in your story that maybe somebody needs to hear right now. And don't be afraid to share that, even if it's scary. All right, so those are my three B's. I want to hear yours. Please comment if you feel comfortable doing so. Let me know all three, or you can just pick one and let me know. But I would be really interested to hear the reasons why. Like, we talked about doing our B statements yesterday, but I didn't really cover any of the why behind it. So if you feel comfortable sharing that, I would love to hear it too. And again, when you share, you are inspiring others. So be brave, be vulnerable, and please share your stories. All right, so you can comment on this video or you can pop into our private Rediscover Me Challenge group. If you're not a member of that group yet, sign up at getyourprettyon.com/newyou, and we will send you the emails and you can get in that group as well. All right, guys, I hope you have an awesome weekend. I am off to work out with Aubrey, so this should be fun. All right, I will see you guys back here tomorrow morning. Thanks for tuning in. Bye.